Previously on Bull.
We're going to take over Wesley Industries.
This is a pissing contest between him and his grandfather.
You have a deal for me. Let me guess, it's bigger than a bread box.
Wesley Industries.
$5 million for resigning from HSD Capital.
Love had nothing to do with us.
Love had everything to do with us.
How could I possibly love you? And after 2 years, I don't know anything about you.
Keep up the good work.
That's what you pay me for, right?
I pull this off, you close.
Hunter bailed.
He resigned from the firm.
To do what?
Our client made a $1 billion tender offer for Wesley Industries.
You really don't know.
Meriwether Marks revealed that their client in the takeover battle is venture capitalist Carolyn Roberts Cox, sister to HSD Capital partner Robert Roberts III.
Oh, now if you'd only done that against Lincoln, we'd have been state champs.
Yeah, honey. It's a lot easier in B school, too.
Yeah, tell me about it. What say? Time to back it in. It's almost two.
The Kaiser raised his bid $1 a share.
Mm-hmm.
We have to submit our offer in 48 hours. We don't come up with something, we're toast.
I like toast. Lots of jelly.
Come on, Pam. I can't concentrate when you're...
So let me clear your head.
Not now.
I knew it. You think I look like a house?
I didn't say that.
Yeah, but you were thinking it.
Pam, this is our future. The only thing I'm thinking about is finding another $20 million for the Wesley takeover.
Well, then let me get my purse.
You really should get some sleep.
I'd rather get some Maui brownie madness. Damn it. I can get it.
You should relax. I just don't want anything to happen.
I'm not made of glass, you know.
And there's no reason to take any chances.
You know, you are a worrywart, Carson Boyd. You worry about me. You worry about this HBO.
You mean the LBO.
You say tomato, I say tomato.
It's a leveraged buyout.
Let's just get mushy.
I can't. I mean, because you...
I look like a house.
The baby.
I won't tell her if you won't. I miss you, Carr. Don't you miss me?
This is a $1 billion purchase. This is our fee.
Mm-hmm.
It is $20 million. Are you sure this is okay?
Mm-hmm. Ooh, $20 million. Where do you think you're going? Sit down, Daddy, and start crunching numbers. Okay, let's make her exit graciously.
Yeah, that's the spirit.
What do you want, Marty? Meriwether raised its offer to $96 a share. We are log jammed at 95. Don't you have phones to answer? That is a loser's bet even for you.
They squeezed an extra $2 out of the deal, so can we. Kelly, I need copies of those updated financials ASAP.
Listen, we've always got our newfound $5 million in the bank.
Yeah, until we find out where it came from, we don't touch it.
Face facts, we have tapped out every potential investor we've got.
Yeah, speak for yourself, sweetie.
Yeah, well, if we had Hunter's black book.
Well, we don't.
Well, what about the Luckingbill Trust?
Firmly into blue chips. Don't waste your breath. We're screwed. I mean, we don't even know if Blackstone will stay.
He'll stay, believe me. He'll stay.
Why? Because you treated him to dinner?
As a matter of fact, yes.
Keep on dreaming.
You know what? I am sick of this.
Can it, Martin?
No, this isn't like this is my first deal.
I thought this was our deal.
Listen, I never needed Hunter to hold my hand before, and I don't need him now. You don't want to be a part of this? Fine. You know where the door is.
Okay. Let's take a little breather here. All right, Marty? Allison has a valid point.
Thanks.
And so does Marty. But our offer is due tomorrow, so we got to put our heads together for the next 24 hours and come up with something.
I think I have something.
Oh, this is not a practice exam, Carson.
That's right. In a practice exam, we couldn't sell off Wesley's radio stations after the closing for $20 million minimum.
And in the real world, the total asset value for those stations is $13 million tops.
But since they're scattered through Nevada and Arizona, if we lump them together and sell them in toto to a company like Kelliger Communications...
Wait, with it, they've got 15 stations from West Texas to New Mexico?
17, to be precise. They're all of a sudden a major player in radio in the Southwest. To Kelliger... the whole is definitely greater than the sum of its parts.
20 million greater.
At a minimum.
And with the additional capital, we could support that much more debt.
Radio stations don't exactly integrate with their overall business plan anyway.
This could work.
This is what I'm saying.
Very good, rookie. All right, Marty, reach your Blackstone.
Done.
Carson, incorporate the sale into the offering papers. Everybody else, on the phones, to the banks, and pension funds.
Sell, sell, sell! Allie, yeah. Sell!
Come on now.
Go on, Rook.
Go, 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 go!
Sure, why not get blood from a stone?
Whatever, it's worth a shot.
Yeah, that's right. Let's delude ourselves. God knows I'm good at that.
If you want to talk about Hunter...
what's to say? He's gone.
Look, I know. I never said anything because...
it is none of your damn business.
Sure. Right. It's not. And it's not like we're friends or anything.
Oh, now you got it.
Fine, would you like to call Garrison or should I?
He's my client. I'll call him.
Fine.
Offered you and I can't make a damn copy.
Well, an offer's only as strong as its weakest link.
Which is me.
Can I be of service?
The thermostat, Denny. Hey, not everybody's mechanical. Now just hit continue.
Thanks.
My pleasure. CNN says this could top $1 billion before it's over.
It just did.
$1 billion, huh? What I could do with that.
You could buy a happy meal for everyone in the country.
Or maybe a couple of doctors for Kosovo.
Sounds good, Russ. Hey, how the wife and kids?
Excellent.
Okay, bye.
Russ Feynman loves the radio thing. He's in for 10 mil.
Great. Draft the revised offer.
$1 billion.
Kind of lights the fire around here, huh?
Well, don't worry about Allison. Somebody's got to keep their feet on the ground around here, right?
This is good, Rook. This is very good.
We'll just have to run the blue sky.
Sorry. Yes, bro?
Yeah, can you give us 5, Denny?
Yeah, you got it.
Do you mind? No offense.
Oh, none taken. You know me.
Can't be too careful. You know what this is, Carson? This is Excalibur. We pull this sucker from the stone, the whole world will know who we are.
Oh, my God. I gotta go.
Hey, bud.
What's that thing right over there?
A perfectly normal baby.
Be careful.
You tell him that I won't break. Well, I wouldn't let her run the marathon. Other than that. See? Would you tell him that sex is okay, Doctor?
Come on, Pam.
He knows where babies come from, Carr. A nice meal, soft music. Whatever else feels right is right. Although, from what I've been reading, you don't have much time. Meriwether isn't used to competition. Oh, that's no problem. Carr's figured out a way to raise the bill.
Stop, Pam.
You see what I have to put up with? Can you prescribe him something? He'll be fine. I'll see you both next month.
It's Richard. Yep. I want you to sell all my Qualcomm. No, no. Put it in Wesley Industries.
Two Bombay martinis, extra dry.
We should wait for the children.
Can't I have a drink with my girl on her birthday?
They've changed the menu. For 22 years on my birthday, I've ordered she crab soup.
I'll talk to Francis.
Don't bother. I never really liked it.
Hello, and happy birthday.
You darling.
Yeah. Are you having a good one, Maddie?
Enjoy your ice cream before it melts. That's my philosophy, counselor. Tell me, how much does a table visit cost Meriwether in legal fees?
Birthday special on the house. Radio stations.
Thank you. We'll sit down. My office at 4.
Hi, everybody.
Honey.
Hi, Gramps. Grandma.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, darling.
No, maybe I should have brought my own lawyer.
I'm on your side this time, remember?
No, CJ sends his love from Tokyo.
Arranging financing for the takeover.
How was the game, Bunny?
Oh, my backhand sucks.
Well, that finishing score really paid off, huh?
I flunked curtsy and they tossed my butt.
The nerve.
So, never guess who I ran into smacking balls at the club. Ellison Jeffers.
Nero double faulted while Rome burned.
Robbie's not going to back down.
Takeover without a buyer. Well, now that is an interesting concept.
On the other hand, she said Blackstone's ready, willing, and able.
What?
Impossible.
You sure?
I thought...
Hey, don't chew me. I'm only the messenger. Am I missing something?
Just that we thought that Blackstone had better business sense.
That's all.
That's all.
You know the man.
Divide up and search this swamp.
You know the mission.
What do you intend to do?
Catch him.
He can be your best. Clooney, Samuel L. Jackson.
David Letterman. Paul Reiser. The cast of Friends. And many more. Hollywood salutes Bruce Willis. Tomorrow at 8 p.m. Coming exclusively to TNT.
The chef is delicious.
You're flown in directly from Alsace.
And the crackers are from Pittsburgh.
I doubt you flew us here from KC for a hunk of cheese, Robert. Actually, Wayne, we want you and a select management group to stay aboard after we buy the company. At your present salaries, of course. Together with stock options for 20% of the company, vesting after 5 years.
And when all is said and done, we'll be partners.
Ah, if we're successful.
We're thinking of the good of the company. With you at the helm, we'll all be better off.
Not to mention that having us involved would give you a leg up with the board.
As I said, the 60,000 employees of Wesley Industries, they're our only concern.
Nothing like New York sincerity. One question, Mr. Roberts. How do we know that after the takeover, we won't become Mrs. Cox's, puppets?
Well, Carolyn's been involved in several management takeovers. Call Clarkson at Worthington, Lipton at Gender Steel.
Naturally, you'll retain your corporate positions, of course. We're not interested in day-to-day operations. It's good business, Wayne. All profit, no risk.
Besides, no one at HSD has been involved in an LBO of this magnitude. They don't have the muscle.
Wallace, have you seen Grandfather's Monet?
Nothing I like better than a pretty face.
Unfortunately, Wayne, and I speak from personal experience, sometimes the acorn falls very far from the tree.
And that would be why my particular acorn's looking at very expensive artwork right now?
Actually, Wallace can't be a part of this when it's over.
There's a great deal of money involved, Wayne. I'm sorry to have to be so frank.
I can appreciate that. I don't like it much, but...
But your son,
has already burned several bridges with our investors.
Wayne, you already have your loyal management team, Abrams, Callahan, San, all at the top of their game. All will serve the company after the takeover. Wallace is a liability we can't afford.
Like my daddy always said, watch your pennies. The dollars will watch themselves. You've got a deal, Robert.
Look, guys, we can't afford not to take this thing seriously.
Well, I don't get it. Why would management side with Meriwether?
They've recruited Wayne Wesley, David Abrams, Mark Callahan, and Leslie Sand.
They've left out Wallace Wesley.
Would you include Wallace?
Oh, point taken.
And this is all that's in the email.
Well, who the hell sent it?
I don't know. That's what anonymous means.
And we know this email is not a joke because...
Or a setup. You have a problem?
Me? Problem? What could possibly be bothering me? Except, of course, us losing any credibility we might have earned. Face it. All things being equal, they have management. They win.
We outbid them. We restructure.
Damn it, Marty. Grow up. Look, we all know this is not about acquiring Wesley Industries. It is about the Kaiser sending Ditto to his room without dinner.
All right. What the hell's wrong with you?
Me, not a thing.
They could have fooled me. You were always behind this takeover. Just because Hunter's gone...
The hell with Hunter. I'm tired of pretending, Dit. I'm tired of pretending I'm something I'm not. You should think about that, too.
If we discount future earnings of the plant in Mobile...
Someone press fast forward. I've seen this before.
Your equity kicker plan? The Kalish Trust in L.A. loves it.
How much?
$6 million.
You're kidding.
Get you some of that. Hey, I'm good. I'm really good.
What?
Two words. Mezzanine financing.
Oh, there's a novel approach.
Selling it to the Seattle Garment Workers Pension Fund is...
How much?
A bushel and a peck.
Translation.
$14 million.
Oh, nice.
Yes. Yes.
That's $2 more per share.
And a buck more than the Kaiser, which means tomorrow at this time, the victory lap is on me. This is such good news.
This is very good news.
Good work. Good work.
Thank you very much. That's why.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, that's...
Let me freshen it up. There you go. It's too bad. I was going to get that one for you.
Why would you do that?
You look thirsty.
Yeah, well, timing's everything.
I can wait.
Yeah, makes me think I'll be around that long.
Like I said, you look thirsty. My name's Jeff.
Good for you.
See, what you're supposed to say is, my name is... fill in the blank.
What difference does it make?
I like to know a lady's name before
I... Make an ass out of yourself?
Buy her a drink.
Okay, look, Jeff. I appreciate it. I really do. But I'm not here for that.
So why are you here?
To have a drink.
I bet you have a bottle at home.
Alone.
Well, I don't see a ring on your finger, so... I bet you got plenty of that at home, too.
Look, Jeff, you and me, we're not going to happen, okay?
You came here looking for something. I just...
Well, you figured wrong.
Well, that's good. That's good, because... I know you're not going to find it here.
Hey, Jeff. How is it you spend your days?
Construction.
It's perfect.
should,
whatever you want.
Why don't you flex and I'll get us a drink.
I can't believe this is your place.
Actually, it's a friend's. He's out of town.
And you got the keys.
What was it, vodka?
Yeah!
Put that down.
Oh, you wanna try some pods?
I said put it down.
Whoa, little doggy.
Put it back where you found it.
Come on, just because I forgot my spurs, huh? Fine. You win.
You know what, Jeff? Just get your stuff and get out of here. Get the hell out of here.
It's just a hat. You want screwy broad.
TNT is giving away big bucks. Keep watching Bull tonight for your chance to win 100,000. Bull will return in a moment.
I think you did good, Marissa Jane. I'm proud of you. Hello?
Oh, sorry, it's me. Good morning.
What are you doing here so early?
Well, your partner, you know, he asked me to look at this thing because it's all jamming. And so I thought I'd get here before you guys, you know. I don't like to get in the way, so.
Sure. Do your thing.
Yeah.
Big day today.
Yeah?
You until 3 a.m.
I was out.
Well, if you're interested, we managed to raise the bid $2 per share. So today we take over Wesley Industries and begin the rest of our lives.
That's great.
Look, it didn't work out with you and Hunter. I'm sorry for you. And it's not exactly like I'm good at this either. Mm. What I'm saying is either you have to let someone in or leave it home in the morning before you come to the office.
Hunter's gone. It's what I wanted. So why do I feel so damn
angry?
I went to a bar last night. I met a guy. Actually, who am I kidding? I picked him up.
He didn't.
No.
Because if we got a call,
nothing happened. It could have. But hey, I can take care of myself. Hooray for me.
Whatever anyone did to you,
it's not what anyone did to me. It's what I did to me. I broke up with Hunter. I picked up this guy. You know, I always thought that if I proved myself, if I was actually an exceptional person, that the gates would open up and let me into the garden.
This deal is pretty damn exceptional, if you ask me.
Even if it happens, it's not good enough. I'm still not good enough to pass through those gates. So what's the point?
You know what? It sounds like you wouldn't want that garden even if you got there. So screw the gatekeeper.
Me, you, and the others. Find a garden that's good for us.
You think?
Oh, yeah. I think.
Thanks.
Just thinking about the summer of 82. Up in Nantucket, you were on the bow, and the wind blew your hair like the wheat in a Nebraska field. I thought I'd never see anything quite so handsome.
Oh, Maddie, that was a long time ago.
Very nice. And Bobby was at the wheel? What a fine sailor he was.
That wasn't Bobby. That was Robbie.
Yes. Yes, it was. Our son never did like the sea.
Bobby never liked much about us.
But Robbie, you were two peas in a pod.
I really should go. The offer has to be in front of the board by 9.
Yes, we mustn't keep you. But perhaps we could summer in Nantucket? Robbie does so like to sail.
Yeah, that would be nice.
Good luck today.
Oh, Maddie, no luck needed.
What can they be talking about?
$1 billion?
They don't have to count it.
Impatience is a sign of insecurity.
Yeah, you're damn straight it is. We have got them beat by at least a buck a share. What's to discuss?
Miss Jones is here.
All right. Send her in.
She's here. That's got to be a good sign.
Glass is half full.
Thank you.
A personal visit. We are honored.
Well, it was on my way. I have some disconcerting news.
Well, you're an attorney, Melinda. Should we expect less?
They outbid us.
Actually, they didn't. $97 per share seems to be a popular figure. The offers are identical. The purchase price, the financing, the restructuring.
Wait, that's impossible.
Except the Meriwether offer will keep key members of management in place.
We lost.
She didn't say that.
As a matter of fact, I'm sorry.
Give us a day. We'll raise our bid.
I don't see how.
24 hours? Could be worth millions to your shareholders.
I don't know if the board will go for it.
Your counsel to the board, Melinda. Convince them.
They're busy men and women. They don't appreciate having their time wasted.
Okay, look, if we can't raise our bid, we'll pick up their expenses. $1 million. We will? Yeah. $1 million for one day in the Apple.
How can they say no?
The offer's due Friday, 2 p.m. Not a second later.
Well, you're quite the swordsman with Blackstone's money.
Well, what's $1 million when you're spending $1 billion?
It's the same offer.
Soup to nuts.
Makes you wonder.
You haven't bought a new car lately, have you?
Me? Yes, there is a leak, and no, it's nobody in this office. Don't even think about going there.
Coming in to gloat?
Hardly.
Great, we accept your apology. Now, what are we going to do about this?
About what?
Someone is telling the Kaiser about every move we're going to make. Somebody has access to all our work.
Did anyone here ask Denny to fix the Xerox?
It's amazing. Same company that brought us ground chuck at $2 a pound.
I give Wesley credit. For years, he's been pouring money into R&D.
So this should raise the bidding, what, $10 per share?
I doubt it.
Robbie doesn't know?
There are advantages to having the CEO on your team.
Sure. What are a couple financial disclosure rules in the history of the world anyway?
Precisely.
Wesley Industries has three
patents pending. It'd been nice if someone had told us.
The value of which was purposely withheld.
$20 million. Oh, boy.
Over the first 5 years, NASA will be all over this.
So, whatever we bid, you would have just topped it.
Up to and including $101 per share.
Yeah, but what if these patents aren't approved?
You ever known our grandfather to make a move without thoroughly kicking the tires?
It was you, wasn't it? The email? I don't get it, Carolyn. If we win, you lose.
He's still my baby brother. And besides, after what he did to Dad, I don't know. I just... Somebody deserves a fair chance against him.
I was beginning to think there was no such thing.
Who am I? I want the truth.
Others.
Your chance at a
$100,000 windfall. This week, Freddie wants you to invest in gold. Now, go to TNTBull.com for your chance to win $100,000. Watch and win big with Bull and TNT every Tuesday night at 10.
Denny!
What?
I thought you said you fixed this damn thing.
I did. I mean...
This is critical, Denny. We cannot afford any screw-ups.
Right, no, I got you. All right.
Call me when it's done.
Yeah, just give me a couple of secs, all right?
That should do it.
You really think Denny?
Well, no, soon enough. If the Kaiser offers $100 a share, Denny's fixing a whole lot more than Xerox machines.
You're on, kid. Printers on Madison and 76.
We really think it's necessary a printer all the way uptown.
Belt and suspenders. Kaiser's got ears everywhere.
I know where it is.
You got cats there?
I even know how to hail one.
Well, maybe I should go with
you. Give the guy a break, all right? Carson picks up the copy of the real offer from the printers. Marissa keeps Denny thinking. Marty, hold Blackstone's hand. The rest of us meet here at 1 p.m. Let's go.
Bunny, at tonight's closing dinner, I want you to let Wayne take all the glory.
Jumping the gun a little bit, aren't we? They haven't accepted our offer yet.
Yeah?
Denny's here.
Well, send him in.
Oh, have you met our little birdie?
Pleased.
What have you got for us, Dennis?
They topped out at $99 a share, like I told you.
I don't really need to know this, do I?
It's all for your benefit, miss.
Call Bradbury. Tell him $100 a share should do it.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Hey, congratulations.
30 minutes.
Yeah, make it $100 a share. Right. Done.
Let's get this over with.
I'm just going to get out here. All right,
thanks.
I'm running. What? I'm sorry, honey. I can't. Slow down. Now? You got another month. All right, call Dr. Migdal.
I can't.
Guys, we should have sent someone with him. It's 12:51.
Excuse me.
Well, maybe he's in the elevator.
Hello?
Hey, does this look like the supply room?
Yo, I'm standing here.
And yo, I told you to leave.
Oh, you want me to book? I'm booking. Figures a dude named Dick.
No, that's me. Dick.
Oh, cool.
Did Carson Boyd give you these?
Oh, the tall, geeky dude?
Let me have these.
Well, unless I see some ID. See you
see that.
Hey, you really are Ditto. Cool tag, man.
Where's Carson?
He said I should fill in. And the county had to go fix some broken water or something.
I told you we should have sent someone with him.
Anyhow, peace.
Hey, kid, come here. Here's a couple of bucks.
All right, I gotta get these to the board.
We know we outbid them by a dollar a share. The board's just doing its due diligence.
Wait, do I go around?
I don't know.
Your thumb is caught, I'm sorry.
Melinda.
Robert, HSD outbid Meriwether a dollar per share.
What?
But Meriwether still has management, so we're going to give each group an hour to improve their offers before the final board vote.
All right, people. Let's start calling. Banks, pension funds, insurance companies, pretty much anybody in your palm pilot. Let's do it.
Hi, it's me.
I'll find a way to sue him.
You can't sue him. He's a mole.
Those little... They set us up. They realized Denny was working for us. They set us up.
I'll sue them.
Call CJ in Tokyo. I want him to talk to Ito Trust now.
3 o'clock in the morning.
The points that Hayashi charges, I can call him any damn time I please.
At this hour. It reminds me of
Bangkok.
Yeah. You can't win, you know.
Perhaps.
No perhaps is, Allison. I'm on the board. I vote.
Your dad doesn't, does he? Why is that, Wallace? It's because he's part of Meriwether's LBO. Do you think it's strange you, the president, completely ignored?
Lord, I have 200,000 shares. Do you realize how much money you're putting in my pocket?
Money buys a lot of things, Wallace. But respect, no can do.
I'll manage.
Treat well, your daddy's the CEO. I certainly think he could have picked his own management team.
You don't know everything.
Believe me, I know all about humiliation. I know what it's like to be the family embarrassment. I know what it's like to be brushed aside, Wallace. You're lucky. Your dad just wants you out of the business. Mine wants me out of his life. Look, whatever you decide to do, you get rich. I know if it was me, I'd do the brushing for a change.
You're a pretty tough lady. Even without Hunter.
Yeah, you got a problem with that?
Simon says not a nickel more.
That's it. They won. We lost.
There is one more way that we can raise the offer.
We're tapped out, Al. We've already hit all the banks.
Look, the Kaiser thinks we're stumped.
Oh, and we're not?
He's going to match your last offer. Sit tight.
And Wesley Industries will be his.
That's right. But if we forgo our fee...
$20 million. Wait, you're serious?
I've never been more serious.
Okay, so if we tack on another 20 mil...
What's important here, guys, is if we don't, come Monday morning, we're going to be cold calling.
Welcome to the garden.
Vote.
sir. Good luck.
The final bids. Gardner Blackstone through HSD Capital bid $102 per share. Carolyn Cox and certain members of management through Meriwether Marks bid $100 per share. This process has been competitive. So competitive that one single vote determined the outcome. The board will accept the bid of HSD Capital and Gardner Blackstone.
Yes.
I told you.
Yes.
If we just worked hard. Knew it.
Sir.
I'm not interested, Robbie.
All right. Look, it's just a deal. It's nothing personal.
Oh, it's way beyond personal.
All right, fine. A little acknowledgement wouldn't kill you.
That road runs both ways. Apparently, appreciation is a concept lost on you.
Don't you see? This is my thank you. I have become exactly what you programmed me to become. You created this monster.
And now it has turned on me.
Like we've got a fine, healthy baby.
What is it?
Monitor's ready.
What is it?
She's fine.
Would somebody tell me what it is?
Your doctor will meet us at the hospital.
Car? What is it? Car? What is it?
It's a boy.
Is 50, BP is 184 over 100.
He's still breathing in that zone. Let's move.
Out of the way, sir. Looks like it could be Cushing's syndrome.
Or a stroke.